Now, as we reported earlier, severe tropical storm Christine has affected over 2 million, with tens of thousands staying in evacuation centers. We'll be speaking now with Social Welfare Secretary Rex Gachalian. Secretary Rex, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Kamina, good afternoon, and good afternoon to all your listeners and televiewers. Thank you for having me.
All right, so tell us about your assessment. Tell us about the action taken at this point, Secretary Gachalian.
See, Carmina, let me just put it in the right context. You know, the president has instructed us from day one when he took office that we have to pre-position goods. In DSWD, the paradigm is we don't wait for the calamity to strike, but rather we have a program called Buong Bansa Handa, wherein we pre-position the goods. Because we're just not talking about storms here. We're talking about earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, man-made disasters, or even fire incidents that happen every day. Mm-hmm. So before Christine struck, nationwide, we had around 2 million family food packs spread across the whole country. In the Bicol region alone, we had close to around 160,000 family food packs spread across the different regional, provincial, and municipal warehouses in Bicol region. So even before Christine struck, we were ready. I have to remember, Carmina, that the first responders will be the local government units. But we do understand their limitations in funding. That's why the DSWD is ready to augment their relief requirements by providing them with the necessary family food packs. As of yesterday, we've already distributed close to around 50,000, and we continuously distribute more family food packs to the local government units so they can do the last mile distribution. Mm. As we speak this morning, we have around 120,000 family food packs still in our various warehouses in the region, and another 40,000 is en route as we speak. So we'll keep on augmenting our regional warehouses and the local government units, provinces, cities, municipalities, can keep on tapping into our system so we can keep on providing them augmentation support.
You know, Secretary, when you look at your social media feeds, you're going to see there private individuals as well, local organizations trying to do what they can to help those affected by Christine, especially in the Bicol region. Can you disabuse, or how will you be able to disabuse the minds of many who say, or maybe thinking, where is the national government? Why are there local civic groups still asking for donations? If it is true what you're saying, that you have pre-positioned all these goods and all these aid packs for those who will be affected by Christine. Secretary.
Carmina, the pictures won't lie. We've been posting our own actions as well. You can also ask the local chief executives if the DSWD has been providing support, which we have. Even up to now, I just got off the phone with Governor Kua of Catanduanes. And yesterday I was over the phone with Mayor Legacion of Naga, Acting Governor of Albay, Vice Governor Glenda. We keep on doing that. But of course, you can never remove the good doers in Filipinos. Any type of assistance will also be greatly appreciated by the victims. These doesn't have to be coursed through DSWD. They can go direct. In a disaster this wide and of this magnitude, any single support is much appreciated by the victims. So I guess we will have to keep on moving on our own, and the NGOs nobody will stop them, and nobody should stop them, because more boots on the ground will always be much appreciated. Mm.
Was this the number you expected? Was the magnitude what you expected? Was this magnitude what you expected, Secretary?
Carmina, from day one, the path of typhoons in the country, plus there's a couple of volcanoes in that region, and the path of the typhoons of the country remains consistent. Though the nature changes, meaning storms now develop faster, the path seems to be consistent. It's always our eastern seaboard, from Caraga to eastern Visayas to Bicol, all the way to Region 2. So for the past couple of years, we've been beefing up our network of warehouses in that area. So that's why, even before Christine was felt, we had, like I said, close to 160,000 family food packs on the ground. One of our largest presence when it comes to family food packs on the ground in regional, provincial warehouses. We've always taken Bicol seriously we take everywhere seriously, but we've always taken an extra precaution with Bicol because you have the presence of two major volcano systems there. You have Mayon and Bulusan. And at the same time, this is the normal path of typhoon during the Burman. They go through the eastern seaboard, normally traversing Quezon all the way to Cagayan, out into the other side, to the Western Seaboard. So, if you ask me if I'm surprised, of course, I'm saddened by the magnitude. But were we ready? As we speak right now, like I said, we still have 120,000 on the ground. LGUs are consistently picking up things from our warehouse. It's really up to the local government units to do the last mile distribution because, as we know, they have the presence in their municipalities and their cities. So if you ask me if we're surprised, we always take disaster seriously and we always plan for it ahead of time.
For the aid pack, Secretary Gatchalian, how many cycles can you afford? Is this going to be, you know, the local government units just getting what they can until supply runs out? Or are you prepared to have another cycle? And if you are, how many more, Secretary?
Carmina, we've already deployed another 40,000 and we're processing another 40,000 today. As the president instructed, we have to keep the food relay going. We've gone through these type of situations before. Remember when in Albay, when Mayon erupted, we ran a food relay of almost 3 months. In another case, in the oil spill in Mindoro, we ran it for a whole quarter. In Carina, for instance, we were able to distribute close to 2 million family food packs in all the affected regions. We didn't stop complying all the way to early recovery. The relief operations doesn't stop just with the immediate response, but there will be a stage where people will go back to their homes and still not be ready to get up on their feet. So we'll have to do the recovery stage of that. On top of the family food packs, Carmina, the DSWD will, the moment people get back to their homes and we can start assessing the damages, we start moving into financial assistance. You have to remember, not everything that they need can be found in those food packs. So that means we have to start shifting to cash assistance, and we're ready for that as well. So if you ask me, when it comes to food, we will keep it flowing. But of course, we also understand that local government units will have to use their quick response. We have to complement and augment each other, because as designed by the disaster law, it's really complementary, where the local government units do the first relay and then they come back to us for augmentation. And then later on, we'll really have to shift to cash assistance.
Okay. When we talk about the challenges, Secretary Gatchalian, be it this particular storm or the others in the past, or maybe more that may be coming, God forbid, what seems to be the challenges ahead of you that you still haven't figured out, Secretary?
Carmina, we've had an experience where three successive storms hit the country. Of course, the challenge there will be how to process as much goods out of our repacking center in Luzon and in Cebu. Like for now, we are monitoring this new low pressure area in the eastern seaboard of Mindanao. Hopefully it dissipates, but if not, then we have to deal with hopefully it doesn't turn into a really bad storm, but if it does, then we'll be dealing with multiple storms. I can't say that we haven't been here before. In fact, there was a time where we were dealing with Mayon, a typhoon, and other disasters all simultaneously happening. But the challenge is it can take a toll on our own people in the department as well. You have to remember, our repacking centers will operate all the way to 12 midnight, and it can be physically challenging. Even if the system's automated, we still need people to direct and mobilize. So the fatigue factor might sink in, but we're not yet there. But we're anticipating that, as in everything else. We have backup contingencies we're in. We will have to add more people. Just as a case in point, I spoke to Secretary Laguesma yesterday, and he's providing us TUPAD or emergency workers to help augment the repacking efforts. See, the repacking system is automated, but there's still a human factor to it. We're in. The people will have to direct where to stack the boxes up. What's automated is the repacking, not the stacking. So we really need more people on the ground, and we're happy that DOLE has provided us with that logistical support.
All right, Secretary Rex Gatchalian, they're joining us this noon. We won't take much of your time anymore. I know that you have a lot of work to do, but thanks for taking our call. Take care.
Thank you, Carmina. Thank you.